Hello, welcome to today's Sunday School online lesson. I hope everyone is doing well. Do you remember who we talked about last week? It's King Solomon. So before we start, let's have a prayer. Dear Lord Jesus, we thank you for another lesson from your word. We thank you for your love, grace, and guidance for us daily. We thank you for loving us so much. May we learn about you more and more through your word and open our hearts to be receptive to what you want us to do. And learn from the life of King Solomon. In your name we pray. Amen. Let me ask these questions to you first, and I'm sure you've asked yourself that already. What is wisdom? And who is wise? Well, a wise person could be a person who knows what to say and how to act in different situations. Wisdom is knowing to do the right thing and doing it. They know the Bible and can use it to answer problems they have in their life. A wise person is usually considered to be older and has gone through many things that help them to be wise. But as Solomon proved, by asking help from God, even younger people can grow and learn to be wise. And we know that there's a difference between knowledge and wisdom. And to make things simpler, knowledge is, for example, knowing all the colors of M&Ms and the ingredients, the calories, etc. Wisdom, on the other hand, is knowing when to stop eating sweets or totally avoiding sweets. Or maybe eating sweets only after you've eaten a real meal. And last week, we learned that King Solomon asked God for wisdom. Here today are two very familiar stories on King Solomon. First is the problematic encounter of the king with two women that showcased the God-given wisdom to him. And secondly, King Solomon's encounter with another woman, the Queen of Sheba. So, one day, two women came to Solomon. They stood before him. One of the women said, "My master, this woman and I live in the same house. I gave birth to a baby while she was there with me. 3 days later, this woman also gave birth to a baby. No one else was in the house with us. There were only the two of us. One night, this woman rolled over on her baby and it died. So during the night, she took my son from my bed while I was asleep. She carried him to her bed. Then she put the dead baby in my bed. The next morning I got to feed my baby, but I saw that he was dead. And when I looked at him more closely, he is not my son." But the other woman said, "No, the living baby is my son. The dead baby is yours." But the first woman said, "No, the dead baby is yours and the living one is mine." So the two women argued before the king. Then King Solomon said, "Each of you says the living baby is your own, and each of you says the dead baby belongs to the other woman." Then King Solomon sent his servants to get a sword. When they brought it to him, he said, "Cut the living baby into two pieces. Give each woman half of the baby." The real mother of the living child was full of love for her son. She said to the king, "Please, my master, don't kill him. Give the baby to her." But the other woman said, "Neither of us will have it. Cut him into two pieces." Then King Solomon said, "Give the baby to the first woman. Don't kill him. She is the real mother." When the people of Israel heard about King Solomon's decision, they respected him very much. They saw he had wisdom from God to make the right decisions. News of Solomon's wisdom spread through nations like wildfire. Now the Queen of Sheba heard about Solomon's fame, so she came to test him with hard questions. She traveled to Jerusalem with a very large group of servants. There were many camels carrying spices, jewels, and much gold. She came to Solomon and talked with him about all that she had in mind. Solomon answered all her questions, and nothing was too hard for him to explain to her. The Queen of Sheba learned that Solomon was very wise. She also saw the palace he had built. She saw his many officers and the food on his table. She saw the palace servants and their good clothes. She was shown the servants who served him at feast, and she was shown the whole burnt offerings he made in the temple of the Lord. All these things amazed her. And because King Solomon's wisdom was really God's wisdom, many of his wise sayings have been written down for us to read and get help from. We find them in the book of Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, and Song of Songs. Do you know any proverb? When I was your age, my mom, sister, and I loved reading the book of Proverbs. It's very practical and real. Here are some Proverbs of Solomon. Let's see if you're familiar with them. Proverbs 15:1. A soft answer turns away wrath, but a harsh word stirs up anger. When you're irritated or angry, this proverb teaches us that it's better to say things nicely and calmly rather than scream at the top of your lungs and say bad words. Next, Proverbs 13:1. A wise son hears his father's instructions. This proverb is very direct to the point. You are considered wise if you hear your father's teachings. Proverbs 22:1. A good name is to be chosen rather than great riches, and favor is better than silver or gold. A good name means what other people think of you. The only way that you can have a good name or reputation is by making good decisions that others see and like being honest and trustworthy. This is better than having all the silver and gold but having people dislike you. So, I encourage you to read the book of Proverbs. There, you will pick up so many treasures that you can apply in your daily life, like in school, family life, friendships, and life in general. Solomon's greatest treasure was the wisdom that God had given him. The Bible tells us that we can find true wisdom too by believing in the Lord Jesus Christ and following Him. For we read that in Him are hidden all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. This is found in Colossians 2:3. So the best place to look for wisdom is God through His Word, the Bible. Have you ever seen a compass and a map? Travelers rely on those. Nowadays, we have Waze and Google Map, but it's the same. They show us the right direction to go. God is our compass and our map. He helps us through life and guides us. God's wisdom will help us make the right decisions. Just like Solomon, we need to rely on and trust God to give us what we need and to ask in prayer for things that will help us be wise. Psalm 119, 105-106b. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light for my path. I will follow your righteous laws. This is our memory verse for the week. So to end our lesson, let's bow down our heads and have a word of prayer. Dear Lord, grant us wisdom so we can make wise choices and be an example for you. We thank you for giving us the Bible so we can learn from you. Please continue to teach us wisdom as we read your word and pray. In Jesus' name we pray, Amen.